So, I'd like to welcome you guys back to my craptastic presentation of East Origin, where last episode, our power-hungry magician of a protagonist was literally tripping balls. How much for making a deal with the devil? Yeah. He had taken some crazy demonic essence and nearly went completely insane. Unfortunately, someone had to smack him out of that, and unfortunately, that person died for it. Okay, that being said, let's move on. Hey, Astral. Football? Not really. Some of the matchups really didn't pique my interest as much. Ow. Double ow. Mostly because I bought the Switch version of Tales of Vesperia today and I spent a lot of time playing that. I hope you'll take that as an appropriate explanation. And I am gonna get lost again. So ultimately where I want to go is you see that big mirror in the far back? That's where I want to go. There's a couple of other chests here I want to check out, so forgive me if I become lost. Although admittedly you have to be lost in order to be found.
Yeah.
It's one treasure chest down. Oh, stop shooting me, please. Yeah, that's not where I want to be. Okay, so I got... need... a chest or two. That I'm kind of not at liberty to discuss, or rather, I'm not really one who's supposed to be talking about that. Okay, yeah, don't take the one that's all the way back there. Okay, I've already been here. Yeah, there's a reason why last episode I kind of wanted to end right before the Hall of Mirrors. Getting lost in here is kind of the norm for me. Okay, again, stop taking that one. Yeah, then again, a lot of other Halls of Mirrors are kind of places where, yeah, it's just, you get lost until you figure out, or at least until you get what the path is. Like, let me just make my way to the big mirror first, and then... that's a lot of damage. Should be the second to last expansion. Okay, I think I missed one somewhere. It's definitely a sack of Clarion ore around here I need to get. Good side over there. This one. Definitely another sack of Clary ore. And ta-da! Usage. Yes. I still gotta wander around a little bit. There's one more thing to look for. There's a chest to my left. Oh, I opened that one already? I opened that one too. I think I opened up all the chests here. I thought there was one more chest around here. Let me see if I can wander around the entire right side. Unless this is pretty much the most rightward room of the bunch. Now. Yeah, I think I got all the chests I can get here. I think the last armor I get... last armor I get after this. Yeah, I think I pretty much got what I needed from here. Get this one upgrade and then let's go upstairs. Okay. And no awkward glowing from up here. Huh. Get going. Yeah. Okay, let's do this. Oh, damn. Stubbornness does win the day sometimes. This is too easy. Okay. Yeah. we're done. We burned the witch. Literally. Alright, let's do this. Going. Fine. There's one more laying around about here. Which fork in the road am I missing? Cool. Yeah, sorry if I don't feel like talking for this segment. This is one of those tracks in the game that makes me go, yeah, let the music speak for itself. Alright, last armor. I can occasionally meets enemy attacks. Alright. Chance to block. I am perfectly cool with all that. Really not much in terms of upgrades anymore. Now that I've gotten pretty much everything else in the game here. Okay, maybe except that chest, which contains a key. Just let him turn around and then just mine it. That spots for the dreaming idol, which I don't have on this run. Okay. Oh, there still is a treasure chest, huh? That's where the last panacea is. Sweet amount of jewels. big bloody mess, but I'll take it. There's just something about this theme that just really highlights just how big the stakes are. Okay. We got plenty of SP. Let's see if we can get out of this. Up. Level 48. I could do it at 48, but it's be about 49 or 50 before I seriously consider it. Besides, 30 minutes in. I'm just surprised at how much he can manage to deflect those. Well, I'm at 120k. Okay, level 49. I guess I could go for 50 if I really wanted to. But then again, it's like, after the next boss fight, I'm gonna be 50 anyways. I wouldn't be surprised if the last sort of grinding would be jewel grinding to get to 500,000 for last perk. Okay. Okay. So I have one in terms of perks. Plus. One more spar. Fantastic. That's not even fair. Thank you. Nailed it. And so we reach Endgame. Yeah, that's not exactly going to work. Hang on, I'll be right back. Sorry about that, I had to step out for a bit. Okay. Where were we? Behold the horror. I do so hate that. Ugh. that settles it. Enjoy the ending, everybody.
Thank you.
So, yep, that about does Hugo's route. So, yeah, personal thoughts on this route compared to Unica. A hell of a lot easier. Almost like much of the tower was really tailor-made for just sit back and shoot everything. Which, to be fair, was kind of fine, and yeah. Something about House Fact being just prone to corruption and all that. Well, I'm kind of not surprised at that. And a lot more reasons why will be shown on the next route, which is, yeah, Hugo's is just more fun. But yeah, overall, I'm gonna say, yeah. Unfortunately, yes, because I did the entire Hall of Reflection, then I had to smack Toa one last time, then I had to take a little unexpected break and then pop back for the boss. Sorry about that little interruption, but don't worry, on replay I'll stitch it together when I put it up. But yeah, next Friday, for sure, we're gonna start with Toll. And yeah, for me, this is gonna be a little bit more of an eye-opener. It's been 7 years since I last touched Toll at all. I mean, I've done Unica and Hugo, like, just recently and also once last year, but yeah. This is gonna be a bit of an eye-opener for me. So, yeah, next Friday, we'll start Toll's route. We will be doing extra mode on hard. Yeah. And even then, though, it's not apparently obvious because my setup for this was a little bit unconventional, but whenever you start the game on a first run and you beat either Unica or Hugo, you will unlock Toll. But the recommendation is do not play as Toll unless you've gone through Hugo's route. Because otherwise, a lot of things will just straight up not make sense. That's just the little warning I'm gonna have, so either play through the route or just watch my run of this. It's only been like less than 8 hours collectively, I think. I guess I can check. Yeah, oh, definitely less than 8. But, I don't think I really have anything more to say other than one, I actually enjoyed this run. Two, I didn't have to overtly grind like mad. Well, except for the Mantis, because screw that boss. What is his name anyway? Oh. Teemos. Screw that boss. And on that sour note, well, I'd like to thank you guys for joining me on this run. So next week we'll do Toll extra mode on hard difficulty. Yeah, admittedly, first and only time I did it was on it was on pure normal mode. This is gonna be quite the learning experience for me for the next few episodes. Anyway, thank you guys for coming by. I'll see you guys next time. Meantime, stay sweet, stay sensational, don't be salty, don't forget to save, kids! And I will see you all later. Have a good night.